In Maryland and across the country, Bryan Nehman, the selection of restaurants that received the Restaurant Revitalization Fund monies appears arbitrary at best and inequitable at worst. Listen to this, everybody. 5% of the 2015 restaurants in Maryland that won a grant accounted for 40% of the total funds. 5% for 40. Nearly 100 businesses received more than $1 million each, while thousands of restaurants got nothing. Joining us right now, because we talked about this, Bryan, with attorney Thiru Vignaraja about a rally that gathered together at Faidley Seafood Lexington Market last Thursday. Joining us is the owner of Faidley Seafood, Dayme Hahn, to talk about this. Good morning, Dayme.
Good morning, C4. It's great to be here.
I appreciate it. And Bryan Nehman is here as well. Look, we talked with Thiru about the gathering of, well, of two dozen businesses, restaurants, that have come together to say, look, replenish the fund. We need help from the fund that was set up that was supposed to help us. Tell us why you're calling for this.
Well, there were over a half a million restaurants. Already 100,000 of those restaurants nationwide have gone out of business, over 90,000. And so when they set up this fund, they knew that they were short what was necessary. And we had they had 377,000 restaurants apply. We were one of those who applied, and only 100,000 got any relief. So there was another 277,000 left out. I believe 177,000 have qualified, but there is no money in the funds. And what this is doing is, we all needed relief. We all went through COVID.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
It is picked winners and losers. If they don't replenish it, those who were able to get the funds for help puts the others that didn't in a bad situation. So we're asking Congress to do the right thing and step up with enough money for the rest of the program. When they set up the rules, for this, they set it up, they asked Congress for $120 billion. They knew they needed about 80. And when they set the goal, they set up the rules that people were funded for their losses. And they didn't, when they only got a portion of it, when they only got a third of what they needed, they didn't rewrite the rules. They used the rules for an entirely funded program. And they knew that it was going to run out.
It's so frustrating.
That's a shame.
I can't understand the amount of money that the federal government has
trillions.
Just handed out like candy over the last year and a half, and to know that there are still restaurants that have not received the money that they have needed. I'm just curious, and you don't have to go into details if you don't feel like you want to, but I mean, how have you been able to survive? Like, what have you done to keep the restaurant open?
Well, luckily had our own door. You know, in Lexington Market, we had our own door. And the city shut us down, on March 17th. Mm-hmm. And the first thing that my father told me was, make sure you make payroll, Dayme. Just figure out how to make payroll. I literally set up a tent outside our door, set up a table, and one of our employees' wives sewed all of our masks, because we couldn't get masks, and we sold from our front door. There were still people in the neighborhood that had no place to go for food. I was selling loaves of bread. I was selling anything I could get my hands on. And we would take orders at the door. I put up a chalkboard with what fish I had. And we were running back and forth, and we kind of like did an assembly line. I had for several weeks, I had our employees doing things like cleaning signs and painting walls and doing things that they normally wouldn't do, and just to make sure that everybody still had a job. We pushed out our shipping. We put on a curbside site. Every email that we had for customers, we were blasting, saying, you know, we're still here, we're still open. I put in answering machines to answer when I wasn't there. But we went to work every day, all the way through COVID. And knock on wood, not one of us got sick. you know, the masks and the shields and the gloves and everything we did worked. You know, sometimes it smelled like the Y in there. I had so much bleach in it. But and we pushed our other business, which was our shipping business. And so, you know, we were then opened to 25%, then up to 50, then down to 25. And you know what? We really busted and tried to do everything we could, and we kept our doors open.
Well, you did. You made it through. Dayme Hahn is on board with us, owner of Faidley Seafood at Lexington Market. Last Thursday at Faidley's, there was a press conference with a couple dozen businesses that are trying to replenish the fund, is what it's called. Get the Restaurant Revitalization Fund monies back in. Now, we had Congressman Doug Trubisberger on our show, Dayme, and he is a member of the Appropriations Committee. I mean, the Democrats are in charge now. We have so many Democrats in Congress here. Have you approached our congressional folks to say, look, you know, we need help and you guys are in charge now?
Yes, the first person I called was Ben Cardin's office. You know, the day we were in the situation where Faidley's was one of the 2,965 businesses that were designated a priority group and awarded funds, promised them, they said they'd be there within 3 to 7 days, and then had it retracted. That we got caught up right at the day of the lawsuit that came out through, out of Texas, that claimed that the even having a priority group was unconstitutional. Well, when this came out, every restaurant was encouraged to apply day one, which we did. You know, it took me a couple hours to fill it out because I'm not an accountant and I'm not that good. And I was calling the accountant and, you know, making sure everything was okay. But I applied in the first hours of the first day. Everybody was encouraged to do so. And obviously a lot of restaurants did. I know that the whole system was backed up that day. But when you applied, you had no choice but to answer the questions they gave you. And page one was about the demographics. We filled the demographics out honestly. We had no choice otherwise.
Right.
So we are a women-owned business, and my father is a U.S. Naval veteran. So those two things put us in the priority group of women and veteran-owned business. And so we were approved. And then when the lawsuit said that you couldn't take priority businesses above anyone else, all the priorities got kicked to the side.
Mm-hmm.
We weren't put back in line in the order in which we applied. We were completely removed.
That's incredible.
And that those funds that were designated for us were then undesignated and put back in the pool, and some of it went to people that applied after us, which is what I couldn't understand.
It's amazing.
It's maddening.
It's our government. It's our government.
Well, let me ask you this, because where we are right now, at least according to Thiru Vignaraja, there's an opportunity to get this standalone bill. This isn't a part, Bryan, of any, you know, big trillion-dollar bill. This is a standalone bill that could be moved, like, quickly through, particularly considering who's in charge.
You would hope that it would be moved quickly through that, because who would be against giving restaurants who need the money and that are still around that what they need in order to stay afloat? It's just astonishing.
What's your next step, though, Dayme? We were talking it through. What's your guys' next step?
Our next step is just to get Congress to listen to us. I mean, that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to first make people aware that this is an issue, that there's a lot of people that COVID's not over. I mean, CDC's coming out with more restrictions. We have no idea what's coming down the pike for us. Cost of goods is skyrocketing. The ability to get, you know, help is difficult. And so if that trickles down, I can't get my beer delivered because they don't have truck drivers at the distributors to bring it to me. And so we're like running to package goods stores to fill in because we can't get it from the wholesalers. The crab industry is hurting terrible with not being able to get the H-2B visas, which is insane. That crab processing in the state of Maryland is not considered an essential food source. All of us in Maryland think it's essential.
We sure do.
but our government doesn't look at it as an essential food source. not like agriculture. And so they fight in a lottery every year for their processors, their pickers, their skilled labor. And that's why our crab prices are through the roof. We're fighting so many battles at one time. And you wouldn't even believe this, but in the middle of COVID, when I was serving people from the door on June 17th of 2020, the USDA pulled Faidley's ability to take food stamps after accepting them for 54 years.
That was incredible. Yes.
Why?
Well, they had a ruling in 2017 that if you co-located with another business that had hot food, we have three separate stalls. We're not in the same same building, but we're completely separate. That our fish stall was considered a restaurant.
Right.
And they took our food stamp license.
I kind of remember that. But we suspended everything during COVID.
Exactly. You would have thought they would suspend that. Look, I want folks to listen up. Go to replenishthefund.org. They're urging, Bryan, more restaurants to participate in this. Go there. Make this call. I guarantee you, Dayme, we'll have you back on and other folks. But we're going to, when our members of Congress come on, ask them to get this done. This needs to go through like yesterday, Dayme Hahn.
Yes, it does. We have a lot of restaurants that are still struggling. And now we have an uneven playing field with some restaurants having money to invest, having money to use to buy more product and survive. And we're talking about an industry that 90 cents of every dollar. I mean, the average restaurant has a 10% profit margin or less. We have less because we have thinner margins in Lexington Market. But all that goes back, whether it's in your employees or cost of goods or rent, which we paid 100% to the city every month through COVID. We never, they shut us down to 25%. They didn't give us 25% rent. We paid 100% all the way through COVID.
Bless you. All we can say is bless you, Dayme Hahn, owner of Faidley Seafood in Lexington Market, and keep the fight going. Yeah. I guarantee you, we will be with you, okay?
Hang in there.
Thank you.
Thank you for hearing our story. Thank you.